Notes are complicated and come in many uses. While it would be boring to go through them one by one, making up some categories will help us understand them. So, I've taken some time, put my two brain cells together, and come up with six easy-to-understand categories to help us learn. Welcome to an ongoing series on my channel where I teach you something about DaVinci Resolve as fast as I can. Nodes, unlike effects when using layers, are designed to be custom and dynamic for any project. This makes them better for making effects in unique compositions, but at the same time makes it more confusing because they don't all connect the same way. We'll start with some simple ones that you'll interact with on a daily basis and then get to more complicated ones from there. There's a lot of nodes not included in these categories, like the fast noise node. If you know what they are and what categories they go to, tell me what they are down in the comments. Image generators. These nodes are pretty obvious. They just kind of add an image to your screen. These include text, backgrounds, loaders, and media ends. You could also include the shape nodes in here, but I won't, and I'll get to why in here in a little bit. Let's take a look at the text node, for example, for this category. All nodes in this category are the start of a node branch, generally only having a mask input that lets you change where it's visible. Text nodes and background nodes take on the size of the timeline by default, while loader and media end nodes take in the size of the image or video being loaded. For both the text and background nodes, you can set custom resolutions to ensure no matter what timeline it's on, it will always be that same size that you want it to be set to. There's a lot more details in the text plus node that we're going to explore in a future video. Renders. This is a small category, but a very important one. Every specialized system in Fusion has a render node to bring them back into the 2D non-vector environment that allows it to be shown on the timeline. In general, they're all similar, but at the moment, only the 3D and particle render nodes are specially unique. Those will be looked at in their own specific videos talking about their own systems. Along with the render nodes, I also partially include the media out node because it kind of allows the Fusion comp to be viewed on the timeline. All of these nodes include a yellow and blue input for the background masks. Each of them include the ability to rescale the resolution just like the previous category. Merges. Paired with the render nodes, each system in Fusion also has their own merge nodes. We have two actually to use in the normal systems in Fusion, and then we also have a 3D merge and a shape merge. If you can find out what the other ones are, let me know what those are down in the comments. Merge nodes have at least two image inputs. There's always a background, and then there's at least one more for the foreground. If it isn't clear yet, merge nodes essentially layer the background over the foreground. In the case of the multi-merge, it literally layers branches of your node tree on top of each other with a layer list. In fact, let's take a look at that node. To use it, first you need a background element. This essentially sets the comp's resolution, so a simple rule should always be to set it with a background node. Set the resolution to whatever you want to use, and after you've done that, all you need to do is drag the pipe from the other node branches over the multi-merge, and it will just connect to the correct inputs and create new inputs every single time you do that. In theory, you can add as many of these inputs as you want. It's just up to you to keep track of them all. Opening up the node in the inspector reveals that each branch has created a layer in this list, which you can also rename. Selecting them one by one shows the transform controls that allows you to quickly and easily adjust the positions and scales for each layer. You can even move the layers to be ordered however you want. Most merge nodes include a transform option, but only a couple allow you to connect multiple branches to them. I'll have a specific video just for the multi-merge node here in the future, and all the other merges will be talked about in their own separate videos about their own systems. Shapes. As mentioned before, shape nodes could be included with the image generators category, but this doesn't just include shape nodes. In all fairness, this section may be a little bit confusing because there's already a whole system in Fusion called shapes, but this category just exists to collect everything that creates a shape together and put it under one umbrella. This category isn't part of the image generators, not just because there's more than just the shape nodes in here, but also because all of these nodes require at least one more node for them to be viewable on the timeline. All mask nodes require being plugged into a background node in order to show up, and the shape nodes require their render node in order to show up. Both types of nodes accomplish the same thing, but they have their own methods of doing the task. Looking at mask nodes, you can see they are very basic and don't even have the option to change the color built into them. They're essentially just a basic shape generator. Looking at the shape nodes, there are more of them, and the controls are much more in line with what you'd expect from regular shapes. But the base controls from the masks are still there, and just like border width, offset, separate widths and heights, connecting them all as shapes. Effects. These nodes act differently than anything else we've seen so far. They generally only have one background input and one mask input. Effect nodes don't start branches either. They sit after image generators, merges, or other effect nodes in the branch. They have a variety of uses, and these honestly take up most of the nodes in Fusion. So let's just take a look at one of them to give us an idea of how they all work. The drop shadow is a very commonly used effect in motion graphics, helping both images stand out and making your entire comp look more professional. In other softwares, you would just apply the effect to the layer, and then from there you just find the controls and adjust it from there. But in Fusion, it's its own node, no applying effects here. So how do we do it? Add your node to the branch. To keep Fusion speeds up, let's place it closest to your image generator. This will ensure that it's not trying to recalculate the shadow every time you have an animation with a transform node, which is also an effect. Let's actually bring that in too. Placing it in after your new shadow effect, you can change the placement size, rotation, or any other normal transform controls. You may notice that image generators, for the most part, don't have the transform controls by default. So the only way to get transform abilities for pretty much anything in Fusion is through either this node or the merge node, masks. Finally, we have the smallest and least category of them all. This does not mean the actual masks. We've already seen that in the shapes category. This is talking about the nodes that interact with the mask nodes. And there's only a handful of them in Fusion that actually have this in common. So we're just going to group them all together real quick and just bring them up all at the same time. This category includes the bitmap node, the magic mask node, the blend nodes, and a few others. And they don't really have similar attributes, but they all just interact with the same area. So I just thought I'd bring them up right now. All of these nodes in this category are just masking effects. You can use like the blend nodes in different ways, but they all sort of still handle the same idea of masking. Let's talk about organizing. So you can organize your compositions with two different things. There's the underlay and the notes nodes. Both of these are very handy, and you've actually already seen the underlay being used all throughout this video. As you can already tell, you can rename them and recolor them. They're very similar to just grouping the nodes together, but instead of being able to collapse them, they're always open and you can always see the nodes that are inside of them. There's not much to really say about the notes node. You can make notes on it, or you can rename it, and I believe you can also recolor it. Also bear in mind that the text size actually depends on how far in zoomed you are to the composition. So that rounds up the node categories, but this is just a liftoff point. You know some tools, you know how to connect them. Next, why don't you learn in this next video how to actually use them in a Fusion composition?